Hey guys, how's it going? This is Chad Grizzly, or also known as Grizzly Bird FPV. I'm going to do a review today on the Xhover B-roll. It is a really neat little machine. It's a 3-inch micro. The features are a run cam split, which is the biggest feature that they're boasting on. It's a run cam split mini. It is a FPV camera and doubles as a HD recording device as well, and it records in 1080p 60 frames per second, which is really, really neat for such a little bitty device. And now you can finally get all that super sweet juicy footage with a micro and not have to show everybody the DVR footage. I hate DVR footage. What it comes with a bag of screws, which is for your props and for your motors, as well as some of the stack screws. It does not come with any of the M3 standoff screws for replacements, but I feel like we all should have piles and piles of those. It also comes with some C-clips, extra C-clips for the motors. But we'll set that aside for now. It also comes stock with 2-inch props. This is what they suggest to use, and I assume it's because they are trying to market it as a cruiser kind of smooth footage, with the HD and everything like that, which I'm sure this is exactly how that works with these. But I like to do freestyle, and you know, that's the whole point. So what I have on here are the 2.5-inch props. This is what I tuned it with. It can take up to the 3-inch props. I haven't tried it with the 3-inch props yet, but it can definitely do that. I feel like these props might be too high of a pitch, and you're only going to get about a minute and a half of flight time, but we'll see. I'll try that out today and let you guys know how that goes. Right now, as far as flight time, I'm getting probably about 3.5 minutes, 3 to 3.5 minutes of flight time with this guy. And that's doing some freestyle and some cruising and things like that. It seems to be doing pretty good. The battery sag is not too bad. I wish this was an XT30 instead of JST. But I think that can just be an easy change out. But I will say, Xhover, make sure you put this information on your website, because I had to do some sleuthing to figure out what the connection was, so I knew which batteries to get. I'm using the Drone by Venom 450mAh 70C 3S batteries, and they're perfect. They fit on there nice and neat. So that's what you need to get for batteries, is the JST connector. It comes with a Omnibus F4 stack. So the stack is right here, as you can see it. On top, it's got the VTX, which is a 25 to 350 milliwatt VTX with smart audio. So that means you can connect this up with your transmitter, and you can change all your settings for your camera via your transmitter. Next down, we have the actual flight controller, the F4 Omnibus flight controller. It has plenty of space for running stuff. The F4 is definitely my favorite to run. It's just got plenty of space. The CPU load is super low, so you can run this at a higher PID loop. It's pretty nice. Underneath here, we have the 4-in-1 ESCs, which I have no idea what their rating is. Again, Xhover has not put any of that information on there, so your guess is as good as mine on these 4-in-1 ESCs. On the Bind and Fly, it comes with either FR Sky or a Spectrum receiver. It's got a little receiver button in there. I don't know if you can see that. Right in there. So you just bind it up to your transmitter and go from there. It's actually pretty easy. It is running Betaflight 3.2.3, so it needs a little bit of an update, but, you know, to be honest, this thing flies pretty good out of the box. It flies really smooth, aside from the jiggly vibratiness that was in the camera, and I fixed that with the tape underneath here. I just put some little gel tape down there, and it eliminated all vibrations in the HD footage. So now, onto things that I had changed right out of the box. Number one, I put that tape down there with the run cam so that it would take all the vibrations out of that. Number two, the receiver antennas were originally taped to the side of the inside of the arm on both sides. I didn't like that. I was afraid I was going to get dropouts in my signal, so I moved them on top like I would with a 5-inch, and that way there's no question about that. And they're really flexible, so it's, you know, you're not worried about really breaking them. And if they get caught in the props, then they get caught in the props. We've all been through that. But I prefer to have it this way. That's all personal preference. On the tuning, all I really did was just kind of go through and take out some vibrations. It really wasn't a whole lot of tuning, and it flies just buttery, buttery smooth. I really, really love it. The motors are the 1106, the Xhover 1106 6300 kV micro motors. They are super, super, super quiet. You almost can't even hear it flying around. Things that I like about it, I think it flies amazing. Again, with just, like I said, a little tiny bit of tuning. Super smooth. It looks really, really cool, really, really, really sharp. And the main feature is the HD footage on the micro. This thing is so tiny, and it comes with HD footage. You can have HD footage, and I'm really, really excited about that, to be able to get all that juicy footage with a micro, get all those little tight spots and trees and under things and things that you can't really go with a 5-inch, and really get that really sweet footage from there. Things that I really don't like about it. Run Cam, I think, has addressed this before, or it has been addressed when it first came out, is the SD card holder is pretty garbage. If you hit a leaf, if you hit a twig, this thing is just going to pop open and it shoots your card out. And you have lost potentially all of your footage for the day. And it's really frustrating because those SD cards, as we know, are not super cheap. That's not Xhover's fault. That is a Run Cam issue. I've seen people fix it with hot glue and tape and various other things. The thing about it is you're taking this thing in and out to get your footage. So I've got to figure out a way to keep it from coming out. I've already lost one card, and that's why I'm having to re-record all this stuff. The other things that I didn't like about it is for the price point. The price point, even after doing the research, and let me finish here, parted out everything by itself, the B-roll airframe, the Run Cam split, the motors, the F4 stack, and the receiver. Honestly, you're not really saving a whole lot by building this yourself. Just go ahead and buy the Bind and Fly, unless you just really are into building little tiny things. That's fine. I love building, but these are little tiny things, and my big old mitts just don't work very well with this kind of stuff. But the big thing is, at the price point of $299, I didn't get a single sticker in my box. And I kind of also figured that the packaging would be a little bit better. It was saran wrapped and heat shrunk, and then it was put into a box with some paper on it. For $299, I want a little bit more security in my investment. So those are the things I didn't like. I think that's about it. I will show you some footage here in just a second. So let's get out there and rip some 3S packs on this little tiny micro.